starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
I said stick 'em up. Now you're spoiling the whole thing. Now come on, Lassie. Stick 'em up. That's more like it.
Are either of you hombres interested in making the trek into Calverton?
Ma'am?
Well, Uncle Petrie's going in. There's a free ride if you're interested.
Come on, Lassie. You can go to jail when we come back.
If they ever reach the moon, I hope they find cowboys there. I can't imagine a world without them.
We'll see.
Please, Uncle Petrie.
All right. I'll leave you and Lassie here while I go down the street to the bank.
Did you hear that, Lassie? Uncle Petrie's gonna leave us here.
Would it be all right if I left my nephew here while I take care of some business?
How long are you gonna be?
Oh, about time it takes for, say, 10 rides.
Sure. What about the dog?
Lassie? She won't cause you any trouble.
Especially to the ponies. She loves animals. She's one herself.
Okay. 10 rides, dollar and a half. Put the kid on Star.
Come on, kid.
You don't have to hurry back, Uncle Petrie.
You enjoy yourself.
Ready?
Yes, sir. Star's a wonderful pony.
Star's the best in the lot. Now keep your feet in the stirrups. Hold on to the reins. Now just relax, fella. Hold the reins easy and Star will do the rest. All right, go ahead now. Giddy up, Star.
Giddy up, Star.
Tomorrow's Saturday. All the kids will be here over the weekend.
And the banks will be closed for 2 days, which means we got a 48-hour start before anybody's the wiser. Especially the sheriff.
Giddy up, boy.
Hey,
giddy up.
That's right.
We better go now, Timmy.
Bye, Star.
Oh, Timmy, you've hardly touched your food.
I guess I'm not hungry.
Son, I understand how you feel about that pony, but there are others. And I promised you someday you'll have one of your own.
But there isn't any other pony like Star.
Honey Star belongs to somebody else.
Lassie, do you think Star will miss us? Or do you miss him?
Well, it's figuring pretty close, but if that potato crop brings a good price next week, I might be able to manage it.
You mean a pony? What about your power saw?
Oh, I never said I wanted one. I was just thinking about it.
Oh.
Of course, when I was a kid, I always wanted a pony, too, but I never got one.
Oh.
Look, I got an extra $15 put aside that I'm willing to throw into the pot.
There, you see, we're all on your side.
I should have known. Anyway, we'll leave it as a surprise for Timmy.
Well, I'm awfully glad that you're finally getting your pony, too, dear.
That, Mrs. Martin, is what I'd call a pretty sly observation.
Dad, I was doing some thinking about Star.
Son, I'm afraid you're going to have to put Star out of your mind.
That's what I was thinking about. I know I can't have Star for my own, but do you think if I prayed for a pony exactly like Star, do you think that would help?
Timmy, prayers aren't meant for the purpose of getting things. Prayers are for thanks, for our blessings.
But I need an awful lot of help. Is it right to wish? I could wish awful hard. That wouldn't be like praying, would it?
Son, I can't think of a single rule against wishing for something. I do it myself, all the time.
I'll be in a minute, dear.
Good night, son.
Night, Uncle Petrie.
Do you think if I wished awfully hard, you'd still be able to get your power saw?
Dear God, this is Timmy and Lassie. God bless Mom and Dad and Uncle Petrie. And God bless all the animals and the birds and some of the bugs. Thank you for everything. I didn't need that sore throat I had. Thank you anyway. Amen. This isn't part of the prayer. I just wanted to tell you that I was wishing for a pony like Star. Of course, I'd rather have Star than any other pony, if it isn't asking. I mean wishing too much. That must have done something. Night, girl. Night, Lassie.
Speed it up. We ought to be across the state line by morning before half this town is wise to us.
For him?
Yeah.
Hi, dog.
You ready for Star?
Send him up. I'll be ready in a minute. Finish packing this stuff quick and chase him with the truck. Let's go.
Side of the road. Pull up in front of them and cut them off.
Wide in case he bolts and starts off again, but don't scare him. That dog bite? Don't ask me. But just to make sure. Me back to the truck and let's get out of town. I'll be lucky if my ankle ain't broken.
matter with... Gee, Star! Star, Star! It's true, it's true!
Hey, what's going on? Well, I'll be...
It's Star, and he's mine!
Wait a minute, son. You can't go claiming a pony just like that.
It must belong to somebody.
Well, that's the little fella from the pony rides.
And now it belongs to me and Lassie.
Son, we've got to investigate this. The pony doesn't just drop out of the clear blue sky and become yours.
But Star did. You don't understand. Last night, after our prayers, Lassie and I wished with all our might for a pony, most of all a Star, and our wish came true. See, that's why Star's here. He now belongs to me and Lassie.
Timmy boy, I know I told you that people can and do wish for things, but that doesn't mean that the wish always comes true.
But ours did.
What your father's trying to say, dear, is that... Well, wishes don't always come true in just this particular way.
Look, son. What your mom and dad mean is, well, you... just can't wish for a particular pony that belongs to somebody else and have it wind up halfway in your room the next morning.
Well, that's what happened.
Son, to be perfectly honest, I don't have any logical answers, but there's only one thing to do. Go into Calverton with the pony and find out the answer.
But it belongs to me and Lassie now. And what if they take him back? You want to belong to us, don't you?
Who's gonna make this check good?
It's up to you, Sheriff, to catch those crooks.
I'll do everything in my power, but please go on home now. Don't worry about a thing.
Hi, Bob.
Hi, Sheriff.
This is the place where they had the pony rides.
It was the place.
Well, I don't understand. I've got a pony that's supposed to belong here.
Well, that's very interesting, because the owner skipped town during the night.
See? Star belongs to us, just like I told you.
Yeah. Well, yes, sir. Well, I know it's your day off, Judge, but this is a special case. It has to be settled legally in court. I'm only an enforcement officer. I can't make the legal decisions. Oh, yes, Your Honor. Yes, I can have him here. Oh, thank you very much, Your Honor. You've saved me from a horrible weekend.
Well, what did the judge say?
Is he going to let Star out of jail?
Judge Baxter will be here in about 2 hours. In the meantime, I got to round up the merchants who were cheated out of their money.
What about the pony?
Paul, it would take another King Solomon to make that decision. Under the circumstances, it's going to be Judge Baxter to figure out, not me.
Good afternoon, Your Honor.
Now, howdy.
All right, all right now. This might be a temporary court, but it is a court. And it's in session. Now, let's have order.
Here's the evidence, Your Honor.
Thank you. Now, from what the sheriff has told me, this matter adds up to one simple fact. You merchants have been defrauded, bilked, swindled, and victimized. In short, taken in by a couple of sharpies. Take that prisoner or whatever you call it out of there. It looks ridiculous.
Yes, Your Honor.
Never thought I'd be presiding at a zoo. And what's that dog doing in this courtroom, Sheriff?
answer that, Mr. Judge, Your Honor. Well, you see, Lassie's here because one half of Star belongs to me and the other half belongs to her. It's our pony.
Your Honor, I have a claim against the pony. They owe me an $18 feed bill.
And I've got $10 coming to me for groceries.
Order, order. This is a pony, not an elephant. There just isn't that much to divide up.
Your Honor, I'm Timmy's father. Maybe I can help. To be perfectly honest, I haven't any idea how this pony came into my son's possession. I can only tell you that I found this pony on my farm this morning, with his head poked in my son's bedroom window.
How did he get there, Timmy?
Well, Star was a wish that came true.
Can you explain that further?
We all met yesterday. Lassie, Star, and me. And then last night, Lassie and I wished, after our prayers, if we could have Star for our own. And our wish came true. And Star was right there this morning.
That's been a story all along, Your Honor.
Are you telling the truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth?
Your Honor, it's difficult for me to draw a line between a young boy's imagination and the brutal facts. But I must confess that I'm responsible for most of the fantasy that's involved here.
Is that so?
I told my son that it was all right to wish for something, if he wanted it very, very much. And also that wishes sometimes came true, even though you couldn't depend upon them.
You were right, Dad.
All right, all right. Now then, it seems we have two problems here. One problem is to try to get back all or some of the money illegally taken from these merchants. And the other problem is to see that a young boy is protected in his honest beliefs so they can't be taken away from him. Now then, the object of contention in this case is a pony called Star. Now, no man in this court can divide up that little pony to pay everybody back his losses. So justice can't logically be served that way. Now, the court is faced with a bigger decision. What purpose can this pony serve in the best interests of all? Well, it's inherent in our Constitution that all people are free to think as they please. And this, by association, allows that there must be an inalienable right to wish as one pleases. And we all know that there wouldn't be any doggone sense in protecting people's right to wish if there wasn't any chance for those wishes to come true. Therefore, I decree that this pony called Star become the legal property of little Timmy here. And providing that he agrees to protect the rights of the other citizens who have a legal claim against it. Now, Timmy, it'll be your responsibility to pay the estimated cost of this pony. The money going to these gentlemen. And I give you 6 months to do it. With 6 months extension, up to 3 years if you need it. Now, court's adjourned.
Lend me 15 cents for a pony ride?
Well, I'm a friend of the boss. You stick around, I'll get you a ride for free.
Here we go. Up we go. All right, Timmy?
All right.